Mortal Shell is the debut title from Cold Symmetry, a studio founded just a few years ago by a couple industry veterans. While it does seem like there was a fair bit of co-development and outsourcing here, the game seems to be a passion project, and you can really feel it when you play. In this video, we will cover all the basics you will need to get started in Mortal Shell. First, let's ensure everyone is on the same page with nomenclature. Mortal Shell is often referred to as a Souls-like game, which is an affectionate name that's inspired by FromSoft's Dark Souls series. Put simply, it involves three-dimensional combat where each attack you make is often a hard commitment. Once started, you typically can't stop the attack, so finding the right time to swing without getting your face smashed in is the goal. Okay, let's begin. The game is called Mortal Shell because you start out as an empty shell and you will unlock shells to inhabit, which can be thought of as classes or playstyles. Each shell comes with a different set of stats and a skill tree of passives to unlock. And don't worry, you can select your weapon separately from your shell. A unique mechanic from Mortal Shell is the ability to harden, becoming invulnerable to a single attack. This replaces typical blocking, which causes a delightful change in the gameplay that we will cover later in this video. Now for the UI. This is your health, stamina, harden status. If you have a last chance available where you can die and get back into your shell to revive, this UI element will be lit up. And resolve is a metered resource used for special moves. Your currencies are tar and glimpses. Tar is lost on death, so be careful, but glimpses are not, and both are used for upgrading. Quick slot items for easy use during combat as usual. What items do will be hidden from you if you haven't used them before, which is actually a fun mystery element. The more you use an item and become familiar with it, it will eventually gain stronger effects for you. And now, playstyles. Each weapon is unique and comes with two abilities to unlock by finding the weapon's upgrade items in the world and attaching them to the weapon at a workbench. A weapon and shell will be located at the start of the three distinct zones that are currently in the game that I call Ice, Fire, and Holy, just based on their theming and the final boss. Your goal to beat the game is to travel to each of the zones, drink the glorious nectar at the end to face the zone boss, defeat the boss there, brutally steal their gland, and carry it back through the zone to the old prisoner at the tower main hub. Now, let's cover all four weapons and all four shells so you have an idea of what you'd like to play with. The Hallowed Sword is the weapon you will start with, and it is a Claymore. It's fast with medium reach and has excellent mix-ups between light and heavy attacks. This is your all-rounder type weapon. Its first ability is a mechanical spike that it emits from its hilt that deals substantial damage to enemies in front of you. Its second ability is the same as the first, except now the spike sets enemies on fire. Whoa. The Smoldering Mace is a two-handed mace with exceptional range. It can be found at the start of the fire zone. Defeat Hadron with the weapon to unlock it. The Smoldering Mace hits like a Mack truck, which means it is slower, but its reach makes up for its lack of speed. Its first ability is a buff that makes its attack set enemies on fire. Its second ability is a massive smoldering explosion. Hammer and Chisel is a quick dual-wield style weapon set that switches between lightning-fast chisel cuts with heavy hammer hits. It can be found at the start of the Holy Zone. Its first ability summons a whirlwind of chisels to attack in an area. Its second ability shoots a chisel at a single enemy, dealing massive damage from range. Lastly, the Martyr's Blade is your big boy's Zweihander sword, and it has long and slow attacks, but it hits hard. It can be found at the start of the Ice Zone. Its first ability is a buff that makes it freeze enemies on hit. Its second ability is an icy explosion that freezes enemies on impact. Each of these four weapons is upgraded separately using quenching acid found around the game world and can be mixed and matched with any shell you choose. Haros is the first shell you will encounter, and much like the Hallowed Sword, is a well-rounded fighter. He has medium stats in every category, and his abilities aren't that flashy, but they are effective. I love Haros because of his fast harden reset and stamina recovery once hardened. Solomon has more max health and resolve than Haros, but his abilities are more specialized. His claim to fame is having the highest resolve maximum in the game, allowing him to store up more weapon abilities and riposts. If you love parrying and using big weapon abilities, this is your shell. Teal is the thief-like shell of the group. Teal sacrifices health and max resolve in favor of a big stamina bar and fast dodging, where you'll see him slip away in a puff of smoke. Many of his abilities are centered around poisons and dodging. Lastly, Eredrim is Teal's opposite. Eredrim has the lowest stamina of all shells, but easily the highest HP. Like a true tank, he can take a beating, and many of his abilities revolve around soaking up damage. So if you enjoy being an unstoppable meat castle, this is your shell. Lastly, there are consumable items that allow you to change your weapon or shell while out in the field. Now let's talk combat. Light attacks are fast, heavy attacks are slow, but deal more damage. You can mix these together freely, so be sure to experiment. Holding sprint and using a heavy attack will be your running jumping attack based on your weapon. Dodge once for iframes or invulnerability frames. Dodge twice to roll away. If you're new to this kind of combat, a safe strategy is to roll away from your enemy with a double dodge to create space and wait for a chance to punish them after they miss an attack. Then simply roll away after punishing them and repeat. Also, rolls don't go through enemies, so try not to get pinned in a corner. While using a weapon ability, you currently are invulnerable, so you can use this to avoid attacks in combat and against bosses. It's honestly probably a little too overpowered to give you invulnerability, but the weapon animations are so long for the abilities, it makes sense why they did give you iframes here. You can parry incoming attacks by hitting the parry button right as the attack is about to hit you. Be sure to pick up the Tarnished Seal from the old prisoner in Fallgrim Tower at the beginning of the game to unlock the ability to parry. Once you do, the Tarnished Seal situated on your back will light up when an incoming attack cannot be parried and warns you to get out of the way. The unique blocking mechanic in Mortal Shell is called hardening. At any time, even mid-swing during an attack, you can harden yourself to become invulnerable to a single attack. You'll also be impervious to ranged projectiles like arrows and bolts, as well as elemental effects like freeze, fire, and poison. It's cool because you can start an attack, harden to avoid an incoming attack. When it hits you and doesn't do anything, you can then release your harden and land your attack instead. This allows the combat to be incredibly flexible. So by combining hardening, dodging, parrying, and weapon abilities that make you invulnerable together, gives you so many options to react in any kind of combat scenario. A simple way to utilize hardening is to harden the last hit in an attack chain where you know the enemy can be punished afterward, and then start attacking immediately after. And if you're curious, Mortal Shell has what they call a Ballista Zooka. It's a shoulder-mounted bolt launcher that impales enemies and has a positively righteous loading animation. For 8,000 tar, you can buy tools from the merchant above the main hub and use them to repair the Ballista Zooka at the workbench. Once repaired, it'll be on your back and free to use separately from any of your other weapons. And lastly, to unlock fast travel or the ability to teleport around the zones in the game, fully upgrade a shell first by unlocking all of its abilities, and then while inhabiting that shell, talk to sister Ganessa to purchase the ornate mask. And that does it for Mortal Shell. There was actually a lot to cover here, but I did my best to keep it short and digestible for you. Thanks so much for tuning in today. I hope you enjoy Mortal Shell. I know I had a blast with it, and I'll see you in the next one.